the stories of the heroes that have risen to the ultimate challenge and triumphed. They are the legends of overtime. In 1986, the Montreal Canadiens entered Madison Square Garden for Game 3 of the Eastern Conference Finals with a confident rookie named Patrick Waugh, who used an overtime period to announce his arrival to the hockey world.
What happened in that game is, my concentration was such a high level that I felt so good.
Race for the puck. Miller tries to beat Chikrin. Does. Good play. Miller cuts in. Save. Waugh. And he covers.
Maybe that's what you call the zone, or, I felt strong.
Austin center, save for all! The scramble is on, he's on top. What a save!
From overtime's opening face-off, the Rangers had swarmed Montreal, but Waugh was unrelenting.
Shot by Melnick, save for all! Rebound loose, save for all! Another shot is stopped by Waugh!
What save by that young man there!
The Rangers are everywhere!
I remember just looking up and watching him make all those saves. Just couldn't believe it.
Lyman to Laidlaw. He shoots. It's deflected.
Oh, what a save!
And it's stopped.
And Patrick Waugh about ready to go beyond unbelievable. Mickey Redmond.
I think it was that the fact that the whole thing was concentrated in 10, 11, 12 minutes, whatever it was. And that's, I think, what everybody was marveling at, is just how quickly it all happened. And they, as the saying goes, couldn't put a pass on the cannon.
Though it was fellow rookie Claude Lemieux who ended the game halfway through the first overtime session, the night belonged to Patrick.
The hot goaltender, you've heard it before, Patrick Waugh was the story as he stopped the Rangers in the third period and then again in overtime.
The Rangers couldn't do anything more than they did. I mean, they played unbelievable hockey.
Have you ever had a game like this? I know you've won 10 already in the playoffs, but 44 saves?
No, I don't think so. It's my best game in my career. It's, when you play like that and the guys play like that and you go in overtime and win a game like that, it's a big feeling.
Waugh's heroics helped Montreal to its 23rd championship and secured his place in Stanley Cup lore. But 7 years later, he was part of an even greater story, the 1993 Montreal Canadiens. A team that reset the standard for clutch play that all others will be measured by. It's a story that nearly ended in the playoffs opening round.
Canadians go home empty-handed, and Pierre Pagé's Nordiques have a 2-0 lead in the series.
Being down 2-0, it's tough because we were playing against a very good team, but it was not the end of it.
We were really confident when we were going in that. Maybe it was just personal, but I knew we were able to beat them.
But despite their confidence, the Canadiens were still forced into overtime in the pivotal Game 3.
Cleared in, Dampus. Nice move! Shooting right on! They score! Jubilation at the Forum and throughout the Montreal area. The Canadiens are back in the series.
If we score that goal, the series is probably over. And they got the overtime goal, and right from then on, they just went on a roll.
Having successfully turned the tide, Montreal won its next 7 playoff games, many of them in sudden death.
Too far. Kearney battling for it. They go crashing in. Ronan and Kearney. Here's a loose puck. Savard. Sabres are stunned. Here come the Canadians. Kirk Muller shot scores! Canadians win the series in 4 straight.
Montreal had now won 5 straight overtime games, and the newfound knack for sudden death heroics gave them a psychological advantage over their semi-final opponents, the New York Islanders.
When they were getting in overtime, I could tell that they were going to win the games, as the other side, we were looking at them and saying, wow, it's been 5 overtime, they won, and you could tell that they were going for the 6-1, 7-1, and exactly what they did.
Here come the Canadians, 3-on-2, Brisebois going to the net, LeBeau, the trailer, scores!
Every time we were going in overtime, we knew it was our game.
Rene won it for Montreal! So the amazing rule continues for the Canadiens. They've won 11.
Rolling into the Stanley Cup Finals, Montreal faced the upstart Los Angeles Kings. But after losing Game 1 and trailing late in Game 2, it seemed the Canadiens' miracle run might well be over.
It was just a couple minutes left in the game. We're down a goal. We would have been down two games going back to Los Angeles.
1:45 remaining. 2-1 Los Angeles.
I remember how crucial it was. Game 2 was probably the most important game of the whole Stanley Cup.
And now you see Patrick Roy, three quarters of the way from the goal crease to the blue line.
We started getting nervous that day. Just think we got to call something here.
A stick measurement has been called. It's the stick of Marty McSorley.
It's a two-minute penalty to L.A. if it's illegal, and it's a two-minute penalty to Montreal if it's fair. And Marty McSorley, if he uses an illegal stick, which he did.
With McSorley in the penalty box, Canadiens coach Jacques Demers made a desperate gamble, pulling Patrick Roy from the net for a two-man advantage as the final seconds ticked away.
And the Canadiens have six skaters against four. Net empty. Big gamble. Schneider ready. Desjardins. No shot. On the outside. Desjardins shot. Goal!
They were so happy that when the game ended up at the end of three periods, tied. They wanted to go into overtime. They knew they were going to win.
Rune carries in, rolling in front of the net, and a shot! Desjardins following the play, and he misses it. The short center is again! Scores! Desjardins! And the Canadiens win in overtime, and the series is a brand new one.
51 seconds into the fourth period.
They had performed yet another in a seemingly endless series of escapes. And having regained the momentum, the Canadiens continued this dramatic march towards the Stanley Cup.
He scores! The Canadiens win the game in overtime again!
John LeClair for the second consecutive game has given the Canadiens an overtime win! Their 10th overtime win in a row!
Playoffs are playoffs, you know. You get into playoffs and things happen, and that year something happened.
And now a 24th Stanley Cup banner will hang from the rafters of the famous Forum in Montreal.
Yeah, for sure. The other teams are, you know, starting to talk about the ghosts and ghosts in the Forum.
I'll tell you, those of us who follow around with the Montreal Canadiens just run out of words this playoff year to describe how this team does it, John.
It's just, I don't want to say it's a fluke, because I think we worked awful hard for it, but I don't think that's a record that'll ever be beat.
Now available on DVD, Pittsburgh Penguins' Greatest Game Box Set, the Greatest Stanley Cup Final Game 7s Box Set, Stanley Cup Championship DVDs, and more. Available wherever DVDs are sold and at shop.nhl.com.
Penguin superstar Mario Lemieux has given us as many unforgettable memories as almost any player in the game. But one of his most incredible accomplishments has been largely forgotten. It was New Year's Eve 1988, Pittsburgh hosting New Jersey, when Mario made history.
Trying to cut the angle off Lemieux and Broughton. Lemieux in. Score! His seventh shorthanded goal. They've got the full 2 minutes. Score! Mario Lemieux, the perfect trick!
Goals at even strength, shorthanded, and on the power play gave Mario a unique hat trick. And when the Penguins were awarded a penalty shot, Mario had the chance to cash in again.